Hello and welcome to this episode of Makerbox Mondays. Today I'm going to have a look at a filament from Filatech called Filatough yellow. So stick around and let's have a look after the intro. So let's have a look at the label. And here they say Filatough yellow should be printed at 220 to 240. And bed temperature should be 50 to 60 and speed not listed and cooling none. And here they say Filatough is an engineering compound filament which provides high toughness, excellent balance between hardness and flexibility, superior high temperature resistance and high chemical resistance to a wide range of chemicals. It thus withstands up to 130°C of working temperature, similar to PC or polycarbonate, with superior high impact resistance, does not contain hazardous chemicals like stearin, which is in ABS or bisphenol in PC. I can't say that word. You can find more information on filatech.store. But let's have a look at the prints. So my first set of prints are summoned in this pile of blobs and issues, and I had really bad bed adhesion problems. I was printing on my Prusa textured sheet, trying out different bed adhesion materials, and I didn't have any good luck. It was warping after the first two layers or so. I got some blobs and issues, and I then reached out on Twitter and asked them about what bed surface should be a good option for this filament, and they said please use a smooth surface like glass or PI sheet, not a textured surface. So I switched out to just the Prusa PI sheet, and then I got a good bed adhesion, and I didn't have any issues with bed adhesion after that. So it was pretty good to be able to call them out on Twitter, and they just provided the support I needed. Here's the maker coin I did, and of course with the yellow it's a bit difficult to see, but it came out pretty nice. There's small overhang issues here because there's no part cooling fan. Overhangs are difficult, but otherwise it came out pretty nice. It's a really bright yellow color and looks really nice. And then printed sheer layers a lot, and that came out quite good. There's a light issue here with the overhangs because there's no part cooling fan. Good, very little stringing, and came out pretty nice. So this model printed quite nicely. And here I did an overhang test. It's a little bit messed up, but for a material that has no part cooling fan while printing, it came out pretty nice compared to some other materials that can't have part cooling fan. And the material it's like somewhat flexible. It's pretty tough, and there's a bottom of a sear layer slot. You can easily flex this, but it's really tough material, and it's a proprietary material. I asked them about the base material for this filament, and they said it was their in-house production, and they didn't give any chemical information, so it's their own formula of resin. It's pretty tough, and when I got the bed adhesion problem fixed, the smooth sheet, I got pretty cool things with this filament. So overall, when with the right environment, you can do pretty tough parts. So I guess this could be a very good option for some mechanical application where you need toughness and some flexibility. It's you can play with this all day long and it won't shatter. I've been twisting this back and forth for quite some time, It's tough. So this will be it for this episode with Filatech Filatough yellow. It surely is a tough material. It's very difficult to tear apart, and layer adhesion seems to be really good, and it's somewhat flexible. So it's a tough stuff, so to speak. But this will be it for this video. If you like what I'm doing here on the channel, please subscribe and like and all that. For now, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.